Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel and thank you so much for watching another video. Today I'm sharing with you how I tackle and get things done as a solo mom. There have been so many new changes for us and still more to come. So as a result of that, I haven't been able to deep clean our whole house. So I'm sharing areas in our house that need a deep clean and just a little bit extra attention. And it's going to be areas that I can get done fast. When I have a solo parenting day, I can't tackle it all. So I tackle the areas that may be neglected or just an all around messy area in our house for the day. Nothing that would take too long to clean at all. I shared with you guys a video similar to this last month. I was going through some pretty hard times, and honestly, I still am, but I'm working on myself. When I shared this video, I wanted to share how I tackle things as a solo mom, and basically when my husband is working and I can't tackle it all that day. I wanted to recreate that video for you because while Jake and I are trying to get our flow back together with this house, we're just trying to take our time because Jaden does start kindergarten soon, and we are just trying to prepare ourselves because we don't know what is going to happen at this point. But between that and of course our other two babies, I can't focus on things that aren't actionable, meaning if I can't control the situation, don't focus on it, or if our house is a mess, just let it be and tackle it a little at a time. I hope that you guys really enjoyed today's video and it motivates you to get up and clean along with me. I'm going to be tackling areas in our kitchen, the laundry room, our living room, and also the hallway. So make sure you guys stick around until the end. I also included clips of what we have for dinner tonight and more special clips of the kids at the end of today's video. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Vantasia. I am a married, stay-at-home, work-from-home mom of three, and I post motivational content like this every single week. If you enjoy videos where you can clean along with me, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss any more of my future uploads. Today I'm going to be deep cleaning and organizing our spice drawer. I know this is a random spot in our kitchen, but I wanted to get it done because having seasonings caked up in the drawer is cringe to even think about. In the future, I'm going to have to get some spice jars from Amazon. Let me know down in the comments if you guys have anything like that and what do you think about it. On this day, it was hard to get things done, so Jake and I made a deal that if I cleaned the kitchen, he would cook dinner, which was completely fine with me. So I cleaned the spice drawer and the cabinet along with organizing Tupperware and then our linen closet. If you're new to my channel or if you did not check out the last video, make sure you go back and watch the whole house clean with me because I am not sure when I'm going to be able to give you guys another long cleaning video like that. With everything that's going on, I'm just going to have to take my time and get things done as I can. Right now I'm spraying Lysol into the kitchen sink so that I can clean and disinfect it. While I let it sit for 10 minutes, I'm going to move on to putting the silverware away. I honestly didn't even intend on organizing all of our Tupperware, but as soon as I started cleaning, I was just like, you know what, let me go ahead and get this done too. Thank you. I shared with you guys in my last video that every single time I am in the kitchen, someone comes into the kitchen and says, I'm thirsty or I'm hungry. I thought it was so funny. As soon as I was done making the boys their water bottles, here comes Jaden walking right into the kitchen. Oh, I'm thirsty. And he didn't even see me making the water bottles. I thought it was so funny. By the way, the sunflower decor that we have in our kitchen, I got that from the Dollar Tree. I really, really love the sunflower decor. I did not want to go with lemons. Originally, I did want to go with lemons, but I was just like, you know what? Let me switch it up a little bit and go with sunflowers. I love it. I still do have plans to redecorate our kitchen. I'm just trying to trust the process right now because everything that is worth having is not going to come super fast. I did move to the laundry room because I at least wanted to get a load of laundry done. I ended up getting two loads of laundry done before Jaquen came home, and then I was really happy because the kitchen was clean, I had some laundry done. So whenever Jaquen got home, we were able to relax. Jaquen cooked dinner. We did take the kids outside for a bit, which I'll show you guys at the end of today's video. And it was just really peaceful. I really enjoyed it. The best part about it all is that Jaquen and I, we were able to get the kids to bed on time, and we were able to do something at the end of the night together. So right now I'm going to start working on our linen closet in the hallway. I haven't really properly cleaned this out since my sister moved out. This is where I kept a lot of her things. Some of our storage stuff was in the closet, but it was just so overwhelming. So I'm going to go through, take everything out, wipe it down, clean the baseboards, and make sure everything is clean. And I'm just using some Lysol spray to clean and disinfect everything. My goal for the linen closet to keep it clean and tidy is to make sure that I only have towels in here, toilet paper. I am going to be switching back to only using Young Living products again, like my cleaning products and my oils. I'm going to try to make some floor cleaner, room fresheners, and things like that. So I'm super excited to get that going. And this is where I'm going to keep everything. By the way, behind the scenes, Jake and I, we were working on the kids taking a bath and things like that. I did show you guys at the end us having dinner and going outside. So don't think whenever you see that we took a bath and then did all of those things, because we didn't.
You special and she reckless. Mbe, you're my bestest friend. Yeah, she my bestie. My love for you is endless. Nobody else can end it. And when I get the money back, then baby girl, you can spend it. And everything is alright. I like how you doing alright, alright. Like how you think alright. Always on top of, yeah, oh yeah. Like how you do it alright. Everything good, alright, alright. Like how you think alright.
This is how everything looked once I was done. The gray basket that we have at the top, that is for our toilet paper. It really does look like we do not own any bath towels, but I promise you guys we do have maybe just a couple more than that. They're just in a washer. Now that I'm done cleaning the linen closet, I'm going to move on and share with you guys what we have for dinner. If you guys really do enjoy clips like this, go ahead and like this video and comment down below so I know to add more clips like this in the future. Don't forget to stay until the end so you can see the end clips, and I still do have more cleaning and organizing to do, so do not go anywhere.
Everything is green over here. Oh, yeah. Everything you want and think about. Now I got your back all the way. And everything is alright. I like how you're doing alright, alright. Like how you think alright. Always on top of, yeah, oh yeah. Like how you do it alright. Everything good, alright, alright. Like how you think alright. Always on top, alright, oh yeah. I wanna know it tonight. I wanna be the one to surprise you.
Y'all, so let me tell you about London. I think this is so funny. She carries this picture around with her. This is my sonogram for when I found out that I was actually having a girl. I don't know what made her cling to this picture, but I think it is so cute. We did make extra food because my sister and niece came over to eat. We had so much fun. I really do love the fact that my sister come over for dinner sometimes and I go over to her house. Since she's been here, it's been so peaceful. I love having her around now. I can just finally have some real girl time. This is how our kitchen looked once dinner was over with and my sister was gone. I did stay up a little late to get this all cleaned and put away. It wasn't a lot though, so it really wasn't that bad. Right now I'm going to make sure I clean and disinfect this trash can area. Now that we have the trash in here, I love that it is not out in the open. With the trash being in the closet, it doesn't ever really smell. 90% of the time we really do have trash bags that are scented, so that's probably why I haven't noticed. Now that the trash can is in this closet, I do want to make sure that I come in here and clean and disinfect it once every 2 weeks because I just cannot take it. It is cringe to even think about. So how I'm going to deep clean and get it all done in this closet area, I'm going to start by taking the trash out, making sure I spray down this trash can, sanitizing it, and then I'm going to move to the shelves above and I'm going to take everything out, clean and organize it, get rid of all the things that we don't really need and put it all back. It seriously makes my heart skip a beat whenever I see Jonah walk up in my cleaning videos, because I remember whenever London used to cling to me like this, and y'all, I miss it so much. You guys, I was working so hard trying to deep clean this cabinet. I even used some toilet bowl cleaner from the Dollar Tree that I usually use on grout, and it still did not clean this, and I was so upset. I used that Q-tip. I didn't use a toothbrush though, so next time I clean this, I'm going to have to use one. Get this as clean as I possibly can, and then maybe I'll go back in and try to paint it, because this is not getting clean how I want it to get clean. How hard I am working for a house that is not even my house. We rent this house. Imagine how hard I'm going to work whenever we actually buy our own house, because this is not it, especially when it's not even our own house and I can't even fix up or do the things that I really want to do. So this is as clean as it's going to get. I'm going to focus on the trash can that we bought, get that clean. It smells nice and fresh. It's not super. Jonah is looking like, girl, who are you talking to? Seeing the walls and baseboards in the laundry room, it really did make me cringe because seeing this really let me know that it's time to go through the house with touch-up paint, go over all the rough areas that are like this. I did use a magic eraser, but the paint started to rub off once I would scrub a little too hard, so I stopped using it. This is the very last closet that I'm going to deep clean and organize. This is the coat closet in our living room. It has everything like decor in here. My dad, whenever he came down, he left a tool bag in here. So I have all of his tools. So I know he is in Missouri freaking out right now. So I'm going to repeat the same process when it comes to deep cleaning this closet. The only thing that I have to say is that the shoes that we have in this closet. So my mom told me whenever she came down here that these were the shoes that she had for the kids. But whenever I was going through the shoes and looking at all of them, I started to notice that all of the shoes, like none of them matched at all. And at first I was a little concerned because I'm like, girl, like what's going on? But whenever I started to look at the labels on all of the pairs of shoes, they would say a size 5, but one of them would be a size 5 and the other one would be a size 6. I know my mom wouldn't do this, so I know it just had to be a mistake on the place that she went to, but I can't really do anything about it because we live all the way in Oklahoma, so yeah. I won't lie though, I was really upset because these were so many pairs of shoes, you guys, and I feel like not only did she just waste her money, I don't know what we're gonna do. So I think next time I go back home to visit her, I'm just gonna take all of these shoes and maybe we'll try to exchange them. I don't really know. So right now I'm going to go ahead and deep clean our floors. This was the very next morning. I had to wait on my Shark steam mop pad to come in. I'm going to be steaming the floors. I will have my Shark steam mop listed down in the description box. I'm just using a few drops of essential oil and I'm using the scent orange. I love to put a few drops of essential oil on the steam mop pad because it makes the house smell so good whenever you steam your floors. If you have a steamer, I highly recommend using a few drops of essential oil on your pad. Floors were so disgusting, so I had to wear the mop socks so I could go through and kind of like put a little bit of extra force on the spots that were hard to get up. Our floor, it does have grooves in it, so sometimes dirt can get stuck in the grooves and it can be really hard to clean. So whenever I notice things like that, I like to wear the mop sock and scrub it with my foot. I know you guys are probably like, girl, you have gone over these floors I don't know how many times, but you guys, I really do love this Shark steamer, and since I haven't used it in a while, I got a little steam crazy. But you guys already know what I'm gonna say. Keep on steaming. It is the perfect time to do this. What are you doing? He is gonna rip it. Huh? Ew. Ew. Yeah. Yeah.
Open your mouth.
Let it go.
Let it go.
Let it go.
Yeah.
What the heck? Uh-oh. Yeah!
Girl, I look horrible.
I'm going to work tonight, girl.